Hello everybody, I'm Sneaksy Gamer, and welcome back to Path of Exile. Now, in the last episode, I got the Sun Orb. And now, I have to go out here. Looking forward to getting out there to that temple out there, or shrine, or whatever it was called. I really am a bit worried about this fight, because I'm hoping I don't have to fight them both at the same time. I can't imagine they would make me fight two bosses at once. What the new topic would have been there. should have checked to make sure that I needed it, to make sure there was something that was going to pick up down here rather than just come down here.
Ask away. Ask away.
It's irritating me. for some reason. Oh well. It'll stop eventually.
Ask away.
Oh, that was completely pointless, pretty much. Okay, not completely, but damn near. I kinda wanna clear the whole bridge. I feel like this side of the bridge was a lot longer than the other side though.
It's another busy day in the land of the dead. The necrotic juices are growing thin around here, Exile. And my sculptures.
Heathen wand. Dang. That's one of them. One of the America the Steel ones.
At your service.
Took long enough for me to see one of them ones, I guess. Ooh, damn. Damn. That's a shitload of damage. Beats this one most definitely. Holy shit. Holy crap, like 400 damage almost. Yeah, that's definitely worth switching. Sure it won't, but that one would increase even better. Wow.
Yes. See you.
Ask away. Happy to share my hard-earned wisdom.
Connect these ones, I could throw that on there actually, and that would make it go much faster, considering I use that one more anyways.
Perfectly lovely work for a breather.
Ask away.
quite happy with the with that new weapon.
Happy to share my hard-earned wisdom. Ask away.
Seem to have reached the end of the bridge. So all I have left is that fall side area, and then I can go and fight the bosses, I guess. Oh, Raven Mask. That it. I saw that and I couldn't tell what it said. I thought it said something different, so I wanted to double check and make sure it wasn't something that I wanted. Apparently there's not anything over there. There goes. Oh, these guys, I think. Yeah, that's one of those guys.
Ask away.
Okay, that wasn't too difficult. could actually be very useful. Missed a section on the bridge over here. What the hell am I doing, man? I know there's no way I can fit that thing in here. It's time to head to town. And then I'll come back out and grab that and head for the Sky Shrine or whatever the hell it's called. Okay, let's go. I'm not looking forward to this, but I do want to get it done. How the hell are people supposed to beat these things without getting killed? Oh, fire resistance 47, 53 for my cold resistance.
Hello.
Don't have any two storms.
See you. Gonna have to keep going with it. I can't say I'm not determined.
Get hit by any of the attacks and it kills me instantly. That especially. Jesus Christ. Seriously, how in the hell are people supposed to survive these fights? I must have my character built way wrong or something. Like, seriously, my character must not be built right at all. that or I'm just not fighting properly. Maybe I'm just not being careful enough during the fights. Because it does seem pretty easy to avoid attacks if you're careful, actually. Except for that shit, there's just so goddamn much going on in the fight at once that it makes it so difficult to avoid anything. Especially this part. I'd never be able to have a hardcore character in this game because I would. I would die too easily. I mean, seriously, look at that. Now I'm just kind of giving up on trying to avoid the attacks because it's so goddamn hard to do it, but it's just pointless if you ask me. Like, why should I be trying to avoid them when I know I'm gonna get killed anyways? Now, I could use the ring that I was thinking of using. This one. This should appear to be helpful this year. Or not. I noise is fucking annoying.
Ask away.
I'm thinking something broke there. It shouldn't be continuing that noise. I can pretty much guarantee something's not working right there. Hoping when I came back it stopped. That was too much to ask for.
Happy to share my hard-earned wisdom with you.
I wish there was a way to just, like, tell it to just identify everything. Blood aqueduct. That seems bad. It seems like a very bad thing. Right, I forgot to switch back to my normal ring. So far, these things aren't too difficult to fight.
Ask away. Ask away.
You have offered us the greatest of gifts, freedom. With these divine tyrants gone, we are free to live our lives as we wish, not as is ordained. In time, all of San will thank you. For now, let it simply be me. Talakura, go.
I'd thank the gods, but you seem to be taking them out at an alarming rate. Not that I'm complaining. In my experience, theocracy's never been great for entrepreneurs like me. Unless you're in the holy relics business. That's too single-minded, too orderly. Give me chaos any old day, for it is in chaos that opportunity is bred. San can get back to his usual state of mayhem, and I can get back down to business. Everyone's a winner. Good luck to you.
Yes? By all accounts,
there you go. Grigor left without a single word to me, rude bugger. But I suspect his poetic soul has been drawn back home to Izimir. A long journey, but a trip worth taking to find solace among one's own people. Of course, they'll get quite the shock when they see him. Let's hope familial love is as near-sighted as they say. There are the fine tales Grigor will be able to tell them, of course. Come to think of it, now that Dominus has been knocked off his perch, there's nothing to stop the Izimites from learning a thing or two from Grigor's story. They might even consider invading this jewel and raid class tarnished crown. I certainly hope they have just such an eye for opportunity. A man could make a tidy sum helping said invaders navigate San and its many hazards. Good luck to you.
I'm just reading about him because I'm wondering where the hell he is.
Grigor is the butterfly that has lost its wings to a cruel child, and this place of respite has become a cage for his pain, a breeding ground of bad memory. We spoke, and Grigor shared his resolve with me. He can no longer live with the torment that piety has injected into his heart. Like the warrior poet he is, Grigor has ventured into the unknown to find a cure for his body and mind, or die in the attempt.
I wonder if we'll Goodbye. Come across him at some point. I want to get to the next town. get to the next town before I end this. Looks like I should have crossed. Oh, I couldn't cross it, never mind. I'm an idiot. How am I talking about? I might come back out of Highgate once I get there to kill that other thing, because that light coming down all over around it is going to make it very difficult to kill that thing, so. Assuming it won't be too far away, maybe it will, I don't know. Put anything in my stash, damn it, I'm an idiot. What the hell's wrong with me?
Happy to share my hard-earned wisdom with you.
How did I miss that? Damn it.
Ask away.
How the hell did I do that? Maybe I'll just have to use portals to kill them. I know I'm getting farther and farther away from it. It's not going to be any closer. They'll just run back. That's what I'm gonna do. I'm just gonna. Oh. There it is, right there. Never mind. Because now if I go through here. Have that as my checkpoint rather than back there, but I don't know which is closer. They're both pretty damn far away from it. Down there, but which side is closer? This one, definitely. This side is most definitely closer, isn't it? Yeah, I think it is, but not by as much as that. Still gonna set up a portal. Okay, where the hell's my portal? Don't tell me it put it back in the other town. It did, didn't it? Yes, I did kill it. Damn it. Should've just stayed in town. Why is it still burning here? Okay, well, you know, it'd be faster to just do this. Go here, then waypoint over.
The dark ember remains nestled deep within the putrid flesh of my dead beast. With many of Highgate's tunnels now collapsed, we must forge another way inside. I have divined one weak point in the beast's flank, an ancient wound wrought by that Varlish overreacher, Doriani. The wound was healed shut by a thick membrane, but the right decoction should dissolve the tissue and allow us inside. Of course, for a cordial of such potency, I shall require two ingredients of utmost rarity.
Of course.
First, our viscous concoction shall require basilisk acid, a princely poison which drips from the caustic heart of the basilisk. And trathin powder, an explosive substance oft used in the mining of virtue gems. With these two bitter harvests, I shall brew something worthy of eroding the membrane of my decaying pet. Well,
you can gripe all you want, lover. We can't stay here. Not with all this blood.
Where do you expect us to go, Vanya? We have our whole lives here in Highgate.
I don't know. West, perhaps? The Ezemite lands. I don't care. Just somewhere that has unpoisoned water.
Oh, Beast Slayer.
Good to see you again.
Even if you have happened upon us in a rather unruly time.
Shush now, sweetie. There's no need to bother them with our woes.
Oh, they don't know. I can see on your face you haven't heard.
It's Kira. She's gone mad.
Absolutely bonkers.
She's abducted a Yon.
Stolen off with her into the desert. And to make matters worse...
The whole of Highgate is in a state of disarray. There's beast blood in the water.
Usurpers are eyeing up the throne.
And the old gods have risen. If you want my advice, get out of Highgate.
Or save us.
While you still can.
You must have women like us before?
Relic hunters.
Collectors of rare antiquities. Anyway, Vanya and I are the best in the business.
And we need your help locating a particularly rare item.
Sweet. I was working them into it.
It's an ancient sword, belonging to the Maraketh goddess Garakan.
The Stormblade, some call it. A weapon carved from crystal, capable of capturing even the most powerful of storms within its rigid edge.
The goddess lost it somewhere in the eastern desert during her ancient battle against the necromancer Suresh and his undead horde.
According to our research.
Find the blade for us and we will make it worth your while.
We do this ourselves, but what with the political unrest in Highgate as of late?
We fear leaving, lest we find the gateways barred and ourselves without a home.
Okay. So you guys still sell this stuff.
Bye.
Who the hell are you?
You must be the outsider. The beast killer. I am Irasha. And while our soft-hearted chieftainess has gone wandering, it falls to me to make sure this Akara doesn't suffer for it. I've heard the stories they tell of you, and I know better than to pluck the feathers from a sleeping rock. Yet, for the sake of my people, I ask that you keep your peace while among us. Our customs have too often been threatened. Your ways are not our ways. Let's keep it like that. Oyun is gone for but a few days, and already Tasuni sniffs at the throne like it's a bitch in heat, ruled by a man. You need only walk amongst the ruins of San to understand that folly. Well,
jeez.
His desires are but wants and lusts while Oyun still lives. One of my scouts saw Kira and her Dekara near the foothills. They had Oyun bound to the back of a rower like a hunter's prize, and the Sekema feather, a symbol of leadership worn by her captor. Whether Kira works alone or in pack with her brother Tasuni, I know not. Yet I fear she means to sacrifice our Sekema to the vulture of the wastes. Garukan, please, this Akara has helped you in the past. Return our kindness. Free Oyun and return her safely to us. And if this quest is lost, remove the traitorous bitch Kira from this world and retrieve our feather. As long as we have that, the throne of Maraketh will remain safe.
Okay, you're the one who sells weapons and stuff then.
The nightmares are but whispers now, yet like prophets, cowering within crevice and crack. They speak of old God's return and the reprisal of an exile to a beleaguered land. My sister Kira has grown obsessed with the vulture of the wastes, our goddess Garukan. Kira has taken Oyun and plans to sacrifice her. Imagining she can reforge herself as a red Sekema, a warlord destined to unite the Maraketh under her bloody banner. My sister's betrayal is too great for forgiveness. Like a rabid dog wandering the mountain pass, she must be put down. I ask this of you, for you are familiar with such barbarism and will not feel the pangs of mercy that I would. On her person, I suspect you will find Oyun's royal mandate, the Sekema feather. If Kira truly wishes to take the throne, she would need such an item to be considered more than a simple usurper. Bring it to me for safekeeping. And please, return our Sekema Oyun to us if you can. If she still lives, that is. But don't risk your life for hers. I know her mind. She would not want that. Of course.
What do you have to say about Sin?
Yes. I know of that dark god perched atop your shoulder. His image comes forth in my mind's eye, and I hear the sound of his breath crackle against the coldness of our mountain air. He has a different energy to the other gods revealed in my dreams. Less hostile, more empathetic to the plight which humanity suffers. Should his brethren be left to roam free? It seems, Lord Sin, as if you are on our side. Of course.
It's kind of weird to think about. I do just want to see over here. Is this open? Nope. Okay. Oh, that's
yes.
No good.
Be careful.
Okay, that's it for this episode. Thank you everybody for watching. I hope you enjoyed, and as always, I'll see you in the next one. Goodbye.